everyone. I can't tell you how delighted I am to be telling you about this week's English learning. It's all about a beautiful fairy tale written by Sergei Prokofiev. And this poem is called Peter and the Wolf. It's a very long poem, so I hope you're sitting comfortably and see if you can listen out for any rhyming couplets. Here we go. Here's a boy whose name is Peter, opening the garden gate. Out he goes into the meadow. He doesn't stop, he doesn't wait. It's still early in the morning, lots to do and lots to see. Peter's friend the bird is singing in the branches of a tree. Then a duck comes through the gate, looking forward to a swim. She waddles over to the pond. One small hop and splash, she's in. The bird flies down and shrugs his shoulders. You're a bird, but you don't fly. The duck sits calmly in the water. You can't swim. I wonder why. Soon they're squabbling. There's the bird hopping up and down the shore. The duck is paddling in the water. That's what her web feet are for. Such an awful fuss. Have you ever heard a noise like that? But Peter spotted something crawling slowly through the grass. A cat. The cat thinks there's a chance to grab the quarrelling bird, and so she crawls towards him on her velvet paws. But Peter sees. Look out! He calls. All at once the bird flies off back to safety in the tree, and from the middle of the pond the duck starts quacking angrily. The cat slinks round and round. She's thinking, is it really worth the climb? The bird will only fly away. It's a total waste of time. Now, who's this? It's Peter's grandpa. He's not looking very pleased. You shouldn't go into the meadow, and he points towards the trees. You mustn't play out here, you know. It's too dangerous, he shouts. Wolves live in the forest. You'd be really scared if one came out. But Peter's not afraid of wolves. He ignores his grandpa's words. He likes playing in the meadow with his friends, cat, duck, and bird. So Grandpa takes him by the hand, leads him home and locks the gate. But Peter wants some more excitement. He doesn't have too long to wait. As soon as they have left the meadow, Grandpa's rattling his keys. There's a rustle from the forest. A big grey wolf comes through the trees. Climbs quickly up the branches. Duck jumps quacking to the shore. The wolf runs up, the duck runs off, but can't escape her speedy paws. He catches her and with a gulp, he swallows her between his jaws. So this is how things stand. The cat sits on one branch and, not too near, the bird sits on another, while the wolf licks his lips from ear to ear. Peter watches from inside. He doesn't feel the slightest fear. And suddenly he runs back home because he's had a good idea. He brings a rope and climbs the wall. The wolf's still prowling hungrily. He grabs hold of a branch and swings himself up high into the tree. And then he whispers to his friend, the bird, fly down and circle low around his head. Go on, be quick. Make sure he doesn't catch you though. And so the brave bird flutters down and flaps around the animal's head. But every time he snaps his jaw, the wolf just tastes thin air instead. The bird is clever and the wolf is getting more and more confused. And meanwhile, Peter, in the tree, has made himself a fine lasso. I wonder what he'll do. He lets it down. It slips around the animal's tail. He pulls it. it tight. The wolf, realizing he is caught, jumps about and tries to fight. But Peter ties the other end of his lasso onto the tree. No matter how the wolf protests, he's trapped. He simply can't get free. Here's some huntsmen, guns held high. Through the forest edge they burst. They've been following the wolf, but someone else has caught him first. Peter's still up in the tree. Hey, don't shoot, you don't need to. We've already caught the wolf, now help us take him to the zoo. Imagine the procession. Look, Peter first, the huntsman next, leading the wolf and then the cat, and Grandpa looking very vexed. The bird is flying high above, chirping merrily to the rest. See what we did? Aren't we clever? We've caught a wolf. We're the best. And if you listen carefully, you will hear the little duck. The wolf has swallowed her alive. Isn't that a piece of luck? So that's our beautiful poem, Peter and the Wolf. And what I'd like you to do this week is to practice your own performance poetry so that you can develop your oracy skills. So remember, it's about being confident, clear, expressive, not too loud, not too quiet. If you'd like to, you can add actions and maybe even create some character puppets or spoons, as Miss Deacon's shown you, to accompany the stanzas or verses of this poem. I'm really looking forward to seeing what you come up with. I know how creative you are and talented. And the other activity of this poem for this week is going to be a creative written response. So you can choose whether you're going to do a newspaper report, a comic strip, or write an eyewitness diary account retelling the events as if you'd watched them happen. Now, First Snape, you know how much I miss you and how wonderful it is to see how hard you're working and sending me all the wonderful work and things that you're doing. I'm really looking forward this week to see all of your work. And on Friday, we're going to be sharing some examples of the wonderful writing I know you'll be doing. Also, on the links that I've sent you is some wonderful work to do with the symphony that the orchestra depicts the picture of Peter and the Wolf. And my challenge is, can you identify the instruments that represent the different characters? Keep shining bright, First Snape. See you on Friday. Bye.